Microphone test. Hello, hello. Hi guys, welcome to a new stream. First, I have to make some adjustments with the settings, the stream setup. Today, I will drive the Nürburgring 24-hour layout in Daily Race C. I will try to start from last position without qualifying time in the McLaren F1, and I hope we will have some fun there. Maybe I'll set a qualifying time later, but first I have to see how the race goes, which cars are best for the race, and if my choice with the F1 is good or not. Okay, I think everything should work now. Okay, hi again to everyone. I'll do some warm-up here and try to talk a bit while driving. Just say me if you can hear me clear or if the in-game sound is too high again. In the past I had some problems with my streaming setup and the microphone volume was too low and in-game sound too high, so it was hard to understand me while driving. Yeah, just write a short comment if everything is alright or if I'm too if the volume is too low. No, I'm not French, I'm German. Doing this stream in English because I have a lot of international fans and viewers. So, if you want to ask me some questions, write them in English in the chat. Or also in German, no problem. But I think it's best for everyone if we keep this English. I'm not sure if the McLaren is the perfect car for this race. I think it got a little bit higher top speed. Don't know if they nerfed it since the last time, but the last time on this combo with GR3 cars on Nürburgring, the McLaren was really good because of the top speed. It was easy to overtake and also the race pace wasn't that bad. I think there are better cars for a hot lap, like the Toyota, but I'll try the McLaren because I'm going from the back of the field, so I have to overtake a lot and should be easier with this car. In real life, I own a Honda S2K or a Honda S2000. I think it's the perfect sports car. Nice to drive with 240 horsepower. No ESP, no traction control. ABS only. Wonderful to drive and good fun. Especially on this sector, the McLaren is a bit tricky to drive. Doesn't have as much downforce as other GR3 cars. But therefore you have got an average advantage of about 3 to 4 kilometers on the straight. Late over here. Was a bit confused by the shadows. Don't know which time of the day it is in the game. No, I haven't driven the S2K around the Nürburgring. I think I won't do this because I don't believe I would survive this. This car is really tricky to drive even on a normal country road here in Germany. It's easy to lose the rear and start to drift, and I don't know if the Nürburgring would be perfect to do this. Maybe I should have some kind of training there before. But I've done one lap on the Nürburgring in an Audi A6, I think. Yes, it was an Audi A6. Four-wheel drive. And yeah, even this was crazy. So I don't know if the S2K would be a perfect car for me there. Yes, my car has the shifter on the right side. It's a normal European standard car, not a Japanese or English version. Okay, here's the lobby. We got some fast guys there. PG Motorsports, Max Apex. I don't think we're fast enough to get them. But even I didn't do a lap time, I'm starting from P13. That's strange. A lot of other drivers without time, without qualifying times. Yes, the S2K is my daily drive, but only in summer. So at the moment I drive it in during the winter time. I choose another car, have a winter car and a summer car. So at the moment it's the fun time of the year. set up everything off. Sports hard tires. Okay, let's see what we can do here. Don't know if I need to fuel save, but I think I will need, so better be on the safe side. I think Fuel Mix 2 could be good enough for the race. Could be enough to make it to the end. Maybe I need a bit of short shifting also, but just let's see. Sorry for being a bit quiet, but that's hard racing at the moment. Need my full concentration. You. He wasn't even on my high on next to me, so don't know why he tried this. It was obvious he can't overtake there without touching me. A lot of pressure from PG Motorsports. Like I said before, he's a really good driver, he's a A-plus driver. Raced many races against him. Oh, I think he had a penalty. Seconds to P1. I don't think we can do this in one lap. But fourth place is enough. We can reach, and maybe there are some mistakes in front. We can get a third also. Yes, he's in the pit. We got enough fuel, just needed 48-49% on the first lap. Thank you. just saving a bit more fuel. Maybe I need it on the way to the finish. Okay, let's get a Spaniard. no chance to overtake here. I think I need to wait for the big straight. Go McLaren Paro. Okay, this wasn't a good finish. He got a penalty. Yeah, he touched me from the side, but yeah, I don't know. He forced me off track, but it wasn't necessary. Did a lot of fuel saving, so I think that helped. Short shifting helped a lot. I don't think you need a lot of the fuel map, just a fuel map on one and short shifting should be enough with the McLaren. No problem, Lopez. Yeah, this one was fun, I think. I think we can do this again. So, again, no qualifying time. Starting from back. First race, for me, it's always just finding my braking points, see how strong are the other cars, where are my strengths, where are weaknesses on this race. And I think P3 on the first race, that's perfect. Yeah, first two, they were too far away. I think I have their pace on the fast lap, and I think when I start from the front I can challenge them, but starting from back you're just too far away. Even after the start you have like 10 seconds disadvantage, and that's just too much to get it on the track. Hello also to all new viewers. Everyone who's interested, my equipment and all my settings are in the video description below. Just check them out. If you have any questions, just write them into the chat. I'm not reading the chat during the race, normally, only if I have some time on the straight, but I try to answer as much after the race as possible. I don't know how the weather is where you are, but right here in Germany it's really sunny and the sun is coming into my window. It's getting really hot in here. Not the best conditions to drive, but still okay, still alright everything. Okay, sunny Florida, I think that could be even better. Okay, let's get some kilometers on this car on track. That wasn't the best ending of the first corner. Dirty tires, dirty tires. But better doing mistakes on training than in the actual race. Doesn't work to read chat and drive, so just trying to answer some questions. Macaron, no, at the moment I don't play other games. Just not enough time for me to do so. So only Gran Turismo, because I want to compete in the FIA races and also do some videos and streams here on YouTube. And as I have a full-time job, I just have limited time in the seat, behind the wheel, so there's not much time to play other games. At the moment, yeah, I do play other games when I have some time. Maybe when I have some holidays. But yeah, not yet. I think I need to upgrade my racing seat with some cooling system for the summer. I think it will be very hot in here when there's three summer in August. There are some degrees more. Oh, I don't know if I want to do iRacing. I don't do many sims on PC. I've done in the past, but meanwhile my PC isn't strong enough anymore, I think. It was good like 10 years ago, but it's pretty old system. Don't do much on this. So I don't know if it runs iRacing properly, so I would have to get a new PC. And don't know if it's worth for me. I tried other sims on PC, but I always get Turismo because it's the one that I think that's the most fun to drive. It's not the most realistic one, but it's the most fun to drive one. And yeah, that's why I stick to this game. You can call me a little Gran Turismo fanboy, playing this since Gran Turismo 2, having all the games in my room. Played all the games. I think the McLaren it's a good car. It's not the best on slow tracks with slow corners, many corners, but on the Nordschleife with many long straights and high speed sectors, it's perfect. It's perfect for starting last. I think if I would try to get a good lap time and try to start from the front, I would go for the AMG, or I would go for maybe for the Toyota. I think the McLaren it's the best one if you want some interesting races, because you can overtake more easily than with other cars. So that's the main reason why I play this game. I want to have some fun, and so this one is perfect. I think I didn't do many laps on the M6. Don't use this often online. It's not often that the BMW is the meta car, so can't say much about this. Thank you. think we had too much fuel left on the last race, so I can push more at the start this time and still make it to the end. Let's try this. Not the cleanest way to overtake. Damn, this Porsche is slow. This wasn't... No clean defense. Forced me off track. Lucky enough I didn't crash here. It cost me like 3 seconds, this fight. Nevertheless, down to 7th from starting 13th, I think. Not bad for half a lap. Let's see if I can close the gap, even if it's the weaker part for the McLaren on this track. out of the slipstream, that's not good. Yeah, a bit rough overtaking, but things still okay. What do you think? Can't see where place 2 is, but I think P3 is the best we can do here. The Toyota is hard to overtake even with the McLaren. But as always, there's the big straight at the end, and I think could be enough to get him there. But first I have to make sure I don't lose him. Don't lose the slipstream. Fuel looks good still. I think I don't have as much as last time, but I think it should be enough to make it to the end. That was a really early braking. No, he's too slow to through this sector. The guy behind is catching us. I think King Arthur really has some struggle with this. This will be an exciting finish with three cars. Oh, he had a penalty. Whew. Good for us. Podium again. Just going through the comments. gained 10 positions. I think that's not bad. Also a lot of fun with the McLaren here. For those of you who think about what they should use here, McLaren sounds looks like a good choice. As you see, you don't need too much fuel saving, you only need some short shifting, and that's still enough to make it to the end. So I think it's really a good choice. Yeah, downgrade our rating, our sportsman rating. Just have to check, don't want to be at sub 90 points. Don't want to be in the loser's lobby. So okay, sorry guys, have to go to the drawer. Okay guys, I'm back. Just a quick question. Could anyone just check my Gran Turismo rating? My sportsman's rating. Don't want to be below the 90. No, Sheriff, it was my door. Yeah. Okay, SR still on 96, that's okay. Mali 26, es gibt die Seite Kudo Primes. Oder es gibt die Companion App. Einen Moment, ich kann dir die Seite gerade verlinken. For those who are interested in their Gran Turismo stats, use the site. You can enter your online nickname and then you can see all statistics to your account. Main things are the SR rating and the driver's rating. So driver rating, 75,000 points is the maximum. I got this on my first account, and also the sportsman rating with 99 points. You need to be above 90 points, then you're S ranked and you're in the first lobby. If I fall below this 90 points at the moment, I would be paired into a lobby with C and D drivers. So. Not where I want to be. Yes, Jonathan, you heard last to first. But there's no first at the moment. I came in third two times now. From last to first in the top lobby, just see this is when I race here. It's the best lobby at the moment. So it's the strongest lobby you will get when you enter the next race at 16:30. So there are guys with A plus rating and S rating, so some of the best players are in Gran Turismo, and you're just too far away when you have to go through the traffic. You're just too far away to catch them. So like you see on my friend's ranking, it's PG Motorsports with 8.16. I don't know what's the world record at the moment. It's 8.6 with the Huracan. Everything below 8.10, I think it's really good. Those are the fastest guys on this track. And yeah, if I want to beat them and they do 8.16 in I have to do 8.2 in my race to catch them, to gain the time I lost at start. Mali, kein Problem. Wenn du Fragen hast, einfach hier in den Chat reinschreiben. Na cool, Rottenburg ist gar nicht so weit weg von mir. Komme aus dem schönen Schwarzwald. So. Next race, P15 to start. Some A plus drivers in there. Ah, will be tough competition. Don't know if I can do another third place here. So also there's much effect with the traffic. Like you saw the Porsche last time. I think I lost about 3 seconds or 4 seconds just because the Porsche. And that's something that can make the difference in the end. I don't think those are for the same as I. The problem with the Nürburgring is the qualifying lap is so long. Many drivers, they don't do a qualifying lap there because it's just too long for them. They want to race, they come home, they want to race, they don't want to do some qualifying laps. And you see that the race ends and you only have like 6 or 7 minutes to go into the next race, so there's no possibility to do a race and do a qualifying lap and do the next race. So that's always a problem in the Nürburgring on the first day. So if you are able to set a early qualifying time, you will be quite in the front at this race. Dankeschön, Weiße Riese, falls du zuschaust. VV Racing, alles Beste dir. We already got one position, maybe there was some connection problems with one of the others. Crash, big crash there. Damn, the speed is slow on the straight but fast through the corners. First rule when you do daily race C, if you can't pass a car, try to save fuel. both missed the breaking point. I think I had a lucky position to do this. Hope I don't have dirty tires on this corner. Not like it's just too narrow to do some proper overtakings. Need really fair enemies that give you some space to let you overtake. If they don't give you the spaces, it's almost impossible to pass them even if you're faster. Here comes the McLaren power. Oh, number three went to the pit. Two and a half seconds to get that Russian. Not impossible, not impossible. Thank you. keep it in mind, we got 5.6 seconds to max apex. Just want to see how close we are at the finish line. Oh, you got a penalty, you got a penalty. Oh, I think Max Apex, he did a mistake. And another mistake. Can we get him? That's gonna be an interesting last 3/4 of a lap. No, he crushed me. That's a penalty. Yeah, 5 second penalty. That was an unnecessary one. He was behind me, I clearly overtook him. He just braked too late. And pushed me off the track. That's bad, we could have won this. This was an unnecessary one. Oh, P2 isn't bad, but we could have won this. It's just sometimes you don't have the luck you need. Yeah, Apex got his penalty, that's no problem with that, but I lost too much time. And yeah, congratulations, Basic.
Neck.
Good one. He saw his chance and he took it, so no problem with that, but I think the dive bomb or touch from behind, I don't know what it was, it was just unnecessary. Level 1 Gaming? Ja, ich bin Deutscher. Crazy Gamer. Hallo? Hello? Okay, so we had 2 third places, we had 1 second place, so next one needs to be a victory. That's all we need to complete. Daniel Tabarelli, What do you mean with fiber car? By the way, if you feel entertained, just smash this like button. We got 100 people in the stream, but only 75 up likes. Could be better, guys. Just joking. Oh no, I'm not going to the Nordschleife. It's funny because I got some tickets, but I'm in holiday. I'm in Spain during this time, so sorry for that. Can't be there to meet some other streamers. I like the 24-hour race. It's great experience. I've been there like I think it was 7 or 8 years ago. Also for Gran Turismo competition. And to all who've never been there, it's just awesome. The whole track, so many people, and there are like 200 cars going around. Even it's Nordschleife with more than 25 kilometers. There's always action to see, and I was at a Grand Prix track and watched the race from there. It was awesome. Right at the spot, there was my tent was on the left side here at this place, I think. No, it was in front of the chicane on the Grand Prix track, and you can sit there the whole night just watching cars going by and braking, see the brakes glowing in the night. It's awesome, and the sound. It's just a great experience. To all of you who've never been there, just do it, go there. Sorry, watch here, full here. I can't understand what you're writing into the chat. Mali, I take this car because of the advantage of top speed. I can do like 280 on the long straight on the 13er here, And I think the other cars only do like 273, 275 or 76. So I got this 3 or 4 extra kilometers to overtake. And if I do this starting last challenge, that's what counts. I need to overtake, and overtaking through the corners, it's almost impossible on the notch wiper. So there are the small straights where it's possible to overtake with this car, and that's what I need for my challenge. That's why I take this car. And with my age, you see my nickname, it's 1990, so I'm 29. Anyone knows how to ban a spammer? I don't know at the moment. Oh, that's Jim Nico and Carl Starr in the race. Okay, so this won't be a 12th to first challenge. Those two are just too fast. Those some of the best drivers in Europe. But I think we can aim for third place. This would be best of the rest, maybe. Okay, I think I banned him. Oh, there's I just see there's Derek. Also doing starting last challenge. I think also on my last starting last challenge he was there, and I did this some weeks or months ago. Could be fun. What car is he using? Didn't see it. Okay, there is in the Toyota. Didn't want to crash that Ford. Just missed the corner. Oh no, 5 seconds penalty, why? Yes, I pushed him, but he was controlled by his own. Some heavy legs there. Need to get through this traffic on the first lap, because with the penalty on the straight, it's at least like 8 to 10 seconds, I think, and not only the 5.5 of my penalty, it's much more. Like I said, Nico and Carlsen, they do their own race. Without a penalty, I think 6 wouldn't be bad at the moment. 2 cars in front of me, one a bit further. Don't know how big the gap is to the guys behind me. 2 seconds to the next, that's not enough for the penalty. But how far are they behind them? And one is gone. Another one. Now let's see where we are after the penalty. Now get some speed. Come on. Didn't see how much time we had behind, or how big the gap was behind first place, so how much we lost. But it was definitely more than 5.5 seconds. For those struggling with the first corner, you can use this shadow as breaking point. The big shadow. Used a bit too much fuel till now. Do some short shifting, but on the other side I have to get those guys in front. P4 is definitely reachable, but don't know if it works with the fuel, because we use a lot of it. So I have to push and also save fuel. He knew he was a ghost. Pirates aren't a big factor here. We can be pretty rude to them. Third place in front of us, so it's better than what I expected. Wow, third place. Sorry guys, I had to block this spot again. Don't have champagne here. By the way, as you see guys, I don't have livery on this McLaren. If any one of you got a good livery and wants to share it with me, just write me a message on PSN. So, and share your livery and I'll try it in the next race or maybe a video. Yeah, it looks like I need a moderator. Okay, guys, this one will be my last one for today. This race was crazy, even with the penalty. I came in third, so let's think we, without the penalty, this would be, would have been an easy race on the second half, I think. This was like 10 seconds worth of penalty, so easy one in the end, but with the penalty it was thrill, just thrill until the finishing line. Didn't see the streams of Tichny and Super GT. Don't have the time to watch them much because they're racing mostly in the evening time, and I do it in the afternoon, so don't know about the bots. So again, for all new viewers, if you have any questions, just write them into the chat. If you want to know about more about my equipment, check the video description or the stream description below. There's my whole equipment listed and also my settings. If you like creating liveries, feel free to make one for the McLaren and share it with me. Maybe I'll use it in my next video or in my next stream of the McLaren. I think if I've got the time, I need to do a race with a proper qualifying time. So maybe if I can do this week, I'll do another video if I have a good race from the front. Just doing some little experiments here. See where's the limit with some corners. Okay, here we go, ready for the last race. Oh, some Gran Turismo Racing Points drivers there. Hallo an Hellraiser und Set Captain, falls ihr das irgendwann seht. So let's hope for some clean race. Hope I don't get another 5 seconds penalty for mistakes. Let's hope I can keep Derek behind me. Yes, of course, I get a 5-second penalty, even if I let him like 3 meters of space. But he crashed me, he goes off, I get a penalty. Oh my god. Sometimes this penalty system it's really annoying. Oh, Derek in the Beetle this time. Okay, we got 9.6, 9.7 seconds at the moment. Seconds. Okay, this is about 6 seconds worth of 5 seconds penalty, not as much as I thought. More than the actually penalty. So be careful. Started this lap with about 16 seconds behind the leader. I wanna know how much faster I can be. I'm fuel saving again. I think I used 52% on the first lap, so need a bit more fuel saving than on the first lap. But without those fights, it's easier. Can do a lot of short shifting. Oh no, there's no space to overtake for me. Two cars by side by side. One off. Oh no. That wasn't the best option. Didn't see the corner. That's the problem, if you can't pass a slower car in front of you, it might happen that you give the one behind you the chance to overtake. A whole lot of carnage in front. I think we will get the Audi on the straight. On McLaren will be difficult. Same car as we have. Wow, even this one is only fourth place. I think it was a really entertaining one. Hi, Rapid Gator. It's not really fuel saving race, just do a little short shifting is enough, I think. So it's possible just with fuel saving on map 1 to finish this with some short shifting. No additional settings needed. Oh, Derek, he won. He won with the Beetle. That's awesome. But shows we would have had a chance to win this thing without a penalty, because Derek was behind us until we had to serve the penalty. So I'll do a short. No, I can't do. Okay. I'm sorry, guys. Enough for today. Hope to see you in another stream. Not next Monday, but yeah, I think I'll come back in like 3 or 4 weeks for another stream. Don't have time now to do some, but I'll upload some videos in between, so I hope you enjoy them. Make sure you are subscribed, ring the bell so you'll get a notification when I'm on next time. Thank you for watching and have a nice day. Bye.